Hey there friends, how's it going? My name is Kevin and today we're playing The Sims 4. It has been too long, my friends, too long. Ugh!
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
So I've been a busy boy when it comes to The Sims 4. It's been a while since I've built a lot. Usually I get impatient and I just modify something a little bit and leave it at that. But on streams, we've been building a gated community. I think you can probably see it. And no, it's not the mess of a house that used to be his home. It's over here. Jim's gated community, not a prison. Unfortunately, it is $250,000, which Jim does not have. So we're gonna have to set out to make some money fast. I will, however, give you a little tour of why we need it so badly. This is what you see from the entrance. You got big gates, big fence, cameras all over it, watchtowers, and this is just to see what height you are, in case you're curious. It's nothing to do with locking people away. There's a graveyard. Why did I go to the graveyard first? We should start at this side. There's a bathroom. Comes pre-stained for your convenience. I don't know why I went to this after the graveyard. It's probably worse. Look, living quarters with the statue of Jim. Pictures of Jim. Calendar of Jim. And those are all the non-money-making ones. Then you start to move on to the profitable areas, like farming. You got a little farm here that the cult members can farm in. You got content creation here, which it looks like they're just in their home, just doing like some live streams or videos, but they're actually a prisoner, which is so funny because it's not possible to happen at all. Help me. And then you go on to the workshop, which you can paint in and you can knit. You can move on to the hedge maze. It's just fucking terrifying, honestly, looking at it, but I really like it. The gate is here so it can be locked when someone is in. And of course you got the base here, the computer. It's solar powered, I guess. I don't know. I think my favorite building of the whole build is the chapel. I love it. It's a chapel of Jim. And you also got Jim's house, of course. His modest little abode at the back. But once we start to get into the building, you got the watchtower, which is climbable, by the way. You need to climb the watchtower every now and again to just contemplate jumping off. We got the church, which is, again, pictures of Jim. You got a funeral that was just cancelled midway through, I guess. The church has a little back entrance here, which leads down into the basement, which then moves on into this room where there'll be a little jail cell eventually, and moves up through a fake chimney into Jim's bedroom. This is so ridiculous now that I'm actually saying all this out loud. This is Turg's room, in case you couldn't tell. It's all just perfect for Jim. But now that I've given you the grand tour, it's time to actually earn the place. God, I forgot how big the family is. Let's just start playing. I need to find some rich people. Okay, so I have 28,000. This lot's probably worth at least 300. Why do you still sound like a child? Oh wait, you're a teen, sorry. I forgot. It's the bald spot that threw me, but it looks great on you, honestly. You know, you look like one of those cool monks that used to live in monasteries. You look awesome. His self-confidence is ruined for the rest of his life. I don't know if this neighborhood is the correct neighborhood to be in. That family looks wealthy. It's so funny going through my old neighborhoods because they're just ruined. Abandoned prison, lot trades, cursed, gremlins, romantic aura. Nothing like some cursed gremlins to get you in the mood. Just me? Oh. All right, let's edit that out. Oh my god, now that person is wealthy. Look at the size of that place. All right, there's two of them, so there should be two of us so we can fight them. Turk, you're coming with me. Turk just shows up naked. Dude, the cat is looking at you. What are you... Oh my god, look at this place. This is worth way more than 300. Wait, did Turk get in? Did the cat let him in? Oh wait, she's back there. Okay. Just having a meal with her cat. All right, Jim, flirt with yourself. This will warm me up. Okay, Jim is now eating her food. I did not tell you to do this. We're trying to get her on our side, dude. Not piss her off. Turg is going to eat now. Well, you can't get angry at Turg. He's too lovable. He's just going to sit here and eat the entire tray, I have a feeling.
Darfo.
Ah! Oh my god, they're fighting already. Oh, Turg is here to fix the situation. He's going to be the mediator.
Turg?
Turg. And then they're both just like, oh yeah, you got a good point. Oh, what is Jim doing? Okay, Turg, I think this one's up to you, buddy boy. He's off to work. He just flew through the ceiling. There's just a giant hole in the ceiling. She's just playing a bit of Sims 1 and he's just standing over his shoulder like, no. So what you doing? Turg is a shining beacon of positivity for the community. Passing by other Sims will elicit friendly waves and cheerful smiles. Oh, that's so nice.
Ah, soon enough.
Oh, are they going on a date? I asked on a date, but he didn't even ask. She just immediately said yes. Where would Turg take someone on a first date? I think karaoke bar. He would totally go to a karaoke bar. All right, let's sing a duet immediately. Where are you? There you are. Sing with me. Oh, he's gonna impress her so much. Wait, no, it's our moment. Go away. It's nice because they're both equally bad. No one's showing up the other. Look at him go. Are you laughing at us? Why are you complaining about the singing? No one else is enjoying this. Nailed it from singing karaoke poorly. Oh, he's trying to show us up. Dude, don't even embarrass yourself. We're not listening to that. I'm on a date and you're making me look stupid. He just comes up to him. Hi, don't like flies. Sit and talk to your date. No, it's Turg, please. No, you sit down. Sit down. Why are you sitting over there? Oh my god. So, are you a mermaid? Mermaid? What gave you that idea? Oh, how can you recover from that? Because you're scaly. I don't know what it is you're trying to accomplish here, but this is not romantic, it's obnoxious, and this is not a violin bar, it's a karaoke bar. You're kind of ruining it. Disaster. Oh, they're having a great time, despite the screaming in the background. I assume Jim is home from work and he's killing him or something, because that sounds awful. It sounds even worse if you speed up time, just so you're aware. Oh god, she's non-committal. Jim will committal murder on you if you don't marry Turg. Dude, don't tip her, don't encourage her. She just said, I'm non-committal, and then he's like, wanna be my girlfriend? Sure. Wait, why did Jim just walk in and go to sleep on the couch? I'll be your wingman, but like, a sleepy one. Just goes to sleep in the corner. Oh, ain't that nice. Sorry if the nose poked in the eye there, I know it's not very convenient placement. This looks like a good time. Oh. Things have gotten so bad in lockdown that I'm looking at Sims singing karaoke and I'm like, wow, this looks like fun. Jim must be delighted. It's like completing his plot and he doesn't have to do anything this time. He's just sleeping. I can't think of a more perfect moment to propose. Okay, they stopped singing. Now it's just a bit awkward because the dude's just staring at us, but this non-committal lady still wants to accept, so that's the main thing. Well, ain't that nice. Oh, and Jim's coming over to congratulate. Oh, no, he was trying to steal the violin. Never mind. I was gonna elope immediately, but I couldn't bear to marry her without her cat being here. She'd be devastated. A legendary date. I mean, it was a legendary first date. They agreed to marry each other. There's something special in your household inventory. What? I think Turg's date just left without saying a word. Turg's fiance left without saying a word. I guess I'll go home. We'll plan the wedding tomorrow. She's just applauding me just for arriving home. I mean, it is a big accomplishment for Turg to get home alone. No guidance whatsoever. All right, let's plan our wedding. Guest, Jim. Let's invite default as well. The caterer can be Jim Pickens. That's risky. Oh god, here goes Mr. Generic. Oh, the quarry building. That looks like a good place to get married. Turg like metal. The poor bride. Dive for thrills with Natasha. May as well. Oh, she doesn't want to. She's freaking out. Is it because I don't have my mask on? You don't recognize me. Let me get in my formal wear. There we go. Oh, now she's running away. We're just leaving the kid wander around this quarry. What's that? Use needles or something? Oh, that's good. Kids need vaccinations. Okay, let's get married. I don't know where exactly. Oh, someone else is woohooing. Oh, thank god, the kid's over here. Oh, Jesus, my heart. I think they may have just married while Jim is awkwardly standing here looking away. What a beautiful ceremony. It's a hallway to a public restroom in an abandoned quarry. And no one even saw. The only person in the room was Jim. He was looking the other way. Aren't you supposed to be the caterer, by the way? Aren't you supposed to make some food or something? I mean, granted, the only fridge is that one. I don't think that food's in date. Do you have anything in your inventory? He has no food in his inventory, unfortunately. Oh, wait, Turg has some spoiled hamburgers. Everyone, eat up. I think my family's full. I'll just abandon this child. Hold on. She's just left here, abandoned at the quarry. Honestly, your chance of survival just skyrocketed. And now this random woman is screaming at her. There you go, kid. There's a parting gift made by Cletus Harris. Who the hell is Cletus Harris? I just realized that random woman is default. I am so sorry if I offended you. She's eating the burger. Her expression though is still just like, I have no strong feelings one way or the other. Would you like to move in together now? Yes. Why do you not have any money? I really thought you'd have money. Oh, wait, I can't add the cat. Is the cat gonna keep the money from the- Oh my god. Okay, move the cat into default's care and Turg and Jim will move in with her and try and sort this whole thing out. Because while you may not have much liquid money, this house has gotta be worth a bomb. Congratulations on getting married to Natasha. I hope you two are very happy together. Yes, Turg and Jim are very happy together. Oh, here's the burger man himself. I heard that people absolutely despise you now. It's affecting my opinion of you. I don't know who you are. All right, let's try and sell your beautiful home. Okay, I can't combine them. So I need to give the cat to Jim and let's just leave it in Jim's hands. I'm sure he'll figure out a way to take care of it. It's just like, I don't want to deal with the cat. A phone call? I didn't know you get phone calls, was it? Why are you calling me about your dream? This monster thing in our neighborhood and we all had to stay inside, but the monster wouldn't leave. I am the monster.
Oh?
What? How rude. I'm going back to sleep. It's 3 p.m. and you're calling me about your dreams? I have things to take care of, like putting someone else's cat up for adoption. Are you sure? Yes. Get out of here. Ah, a nice happy little tune. That poor woman's gonna come back and her pet is being basically kidnapped. Goodbye. Thing is, now that I look at the house, while it's very grand and everything, it's not got that much stuff. Maybe it's not worth the quarter of a million that I needed. Oh, it's actually 110,000. That's not bad. Oh, and look, Potter. Perfect. I don't remember adding him to my game, but he is exactly $100,000. That is exactly what I need. I couldn't get inside because he's a celebrity and it won't let me in, so I lit his door on fire in the hopes that that'll bring him out. Cast it on the inside of his home. That's a good idea. There we go. There's a fire inside now as well. Harry discovered the fire. Oh, hello, Harry Potter. It is lovely to meet you. A big fan. That's a little bit worrying. I killed that person here too, you know, Harry. He's like, what do you mean killed him too? He goes up and knocks. Yeah, I'm sure you wouldn't mind me visiting, would you?
What? Jim just left the lot for no reason whatsoever. Where's he going? Why? We were just about to pull off the kill.
I mean, I wasn't gonna kill you, Harry. Let me in again. Oh my god, he has a baby. That's unfortunate. Hey, Harry, how's this for magic? Won't be the boy who lived for long, will you? That poor kid has to watch his father burn.
He's just clapping for it outside.
What a useless human being. Not even attempting to put out the fire.
He went to sleep.
I'm bored now. Due to neglect, Mabel is being whisked away to safety. You want to whisk anyone else away to safety while you're at it? Finally. Proof that Jim Pickens is way more evil than Voldemort and way more competent. You were in there the whole time just waiting? Harry Potter fans watching this video are probably very upset right now. But I've said it for a long time. Voldemort shouldn't have tried the killing curse. Should have just lit the baby on fire.
Oh, you guys are useless. You're forgetting the main fire.
I'll take care of it. I just took his urn. Find out what's wrong.
What is this? Do you need bathroom? Food? Your papa burned to death?
Now Jim wants to dance. Nothing like a dance after a murder. Okay, well, I'm gonna take that money and invest it in a gated community. Because I've seen what happens to people if they're not in a gated community.
Here we go. Your forever home.
I know that's not true, but this one's a good home. Look, it's the forever home for many of them, because many of them are gonna die here. There they go. Perfect. Good job, everyone. Okay, and locked door for everyone but Jim.
Perfect.
Okay, there we go. God, the place looks nice in autumn. It looks really good. Power has been shut off. Pay your bills. Okay, that's not a good start. Oh, look, she's gone into the hedge maze. Perfect. I don't know why, because the computer's off. Locked door for everyone. All right, good luck in there. In she goes. All right, you know what? I think I'll end it there. The plan next time. Well, I think the expansion's actually coming out, so I might check that out. But the plan overall is for them to try and earn money various ways here. I'm gonna make different clubs, so one club would be like encouraging them to paint and then they'll all gather at a certain time to paint, and then another club can encourage gardening and they'll all go to the farm and garden there and stuff like that. That's my plan anyway. She's probably googling how to solve hedge maze. But we're gonna leave it there. This has been fun. I've missed The Sims. It's been too long. I hope you enjoyed dropping in with Jim Pickens and Turg Turgson. I don't know if that's his name. I always just imagine it being Turg Turg. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed. I appreciate you watching. I really do. It means a lot to me. If you want to check out more of my stuff, I post every day. I've also got a second channel and a Twitch in the description. But other than that, I'll just thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye for now.